Okay, let's do a suicidal scenario. Okay, we have a 21-year-old female who comes in with her parents who said that her daughter expressed suicidal ideation after the boyfriend broke up with her. The patient denies being suicidal. She's alert, she's oriented times three, and she's a little bit non-cooperative. Her vitals are 97.9, 82, 20, and 115 over 70. She is requesting to leave. After all, she says she is 21 years old. So, with everything you know about this scenario, what triage level is she?
I know she's considered high risk and an ESI level 2, but I just don't get it. Why is she given such a high priority?
Well, that's a concern that many ED nurses have. So let's just go ahead and talk about it because we have a lot of these patients. This patient cannot be trusted. We must assume she's suicidal, therefore she is high risk. If she were to leave and kill herself, you and the hospital would be liable.
You know, she may not get to your next bed, but this case really illustrates process and triage categorization subtleties. Some institutions will have a place for these patients. Others have protocols that require the triage nurse to immediately call for a standby or for somebody to observe her and possibly notify a crisis worker or a psychiatric liaison.
And other institutions may draw labs for medical clearance. So we are actually doing quite a bit for these patients on arrival. But the bottom line is she is high risk and take credit for it. Don't sweat it. Suicidal, homicidal, and psychotic patients are very high risk.